Welcome our market guest then, Dhananjay Sinha, Head of Research at Emkay Global Financial Services, now joins us. Dhananjay, hi, good morning.
Good morning.
So let's talk about the kind of gains that we have seen in a couple of these heavyweights, Larsen & Toubro, Reliance, and they have negated the kind of impact the Bank Nifty has had. What's your sense about some of these heavyweights? Do you think they can continue supporting the market, or will the banks now need to rally for the market to rally on from here and maybe going back to all-time highs?
So I think the recent rally has been on the back of some of the global factors, and we have seen earlier that Fed had a dovish stance in the last statement, and more recently there does seem to be some easing of the gridlock with respect to Greece. So I think these variables have actually buoyed the market sentiment after the decline that we've seen in the previous months. So I think there is a certain amount of bounce back that is happening. With respect to mix, I think the banking stocks are definitely have seen continued drag, primarily because of the fundamentals which have continued to remain weak, and initial indications are that you will have the situations with respect to asset quality continue to remain drag for the sector. Business growth with respect to credit growth, etc., has been very modest. And I think with the recent inflation numbers, the possibility of further rate easing has actually diminished, and the market had earlier expected a sharper rate easing by the RBI. So I think those are the factors that are impacting the banking sector stocks. So as a result of that, other if the index has to remain higher, it has to be balanced out by some of the other heavyweights. And Reliance definitely has done very well for some fundamental reasons. Definitely the other heavyweight stocks have actually taken the positive balance to move up the index. So going forward,
Go ahead, Dhananjay, finish your point.
So going forward, see, the thing is what, if you look at the fundamental thing is that if you look at last quarter and starting from the second half of FY15, and also if you look at the result preview for FY, first quarter FY16, the results haven't been so strong considering the expectation that market had actually built up, let's say 12 months back. So you have seen considerable decline or cutting back of earnings estimates, and finally last year I would say that earnings for benchmark indices was actually close to zero versus an expectation of something like 16-18% a year back. So I think that deceleration or a downgrade in earnings continues to be there, and if you look at first quarter this year also, it is unlikely to be very different. So we from our universe, we are saying that if you exclude the banking stocks and also the oil and gas stocks, the PAT growth for this quarter is a decline of 7% for our universe, and versus that in the previous quarter it was a decline of something like 11%. So the decline is lesser, but yet it is a decline, and the top line growth is very modest. So I think from a fundamental standpoint, I think that disparity with respect to multiples and fundamentals continues to be there. But I think what the market is really looking at this juncture is what are the incremental dynamics from a global standpoint, what is happening in China, what's the liquidity scenario, what's happening to dollar. A lot of these multiple variables are actually considered for the current market scenario, and at this juncture it does seem to be somewhat positive after a considerable decline let's say a month back.
Okay. Dhananjay, let's get to some stocks then. Maruti seems to be on a tear, and it just doesn't stop its uptrend. In fact, we've got a target price from a brokerage at over 5,000 rupees. How are you placed on Maruti, and what's your target price?
So our target price here is about 4,500. I think it is trading at 4,180 or so. This has been our pick for quite some time. And if you look at the current quarter, I think the positive that we are looking at is a strong volume growth. The volume growth for the quarter is about 14%. The market share of Maruti in the passenger car segment has actually risen considerably, and there is reasonable support from the export business also. And in general, the decline in commodity prices seem to have actually been positive for Maruti in terms of margin. So there is a margin expansion of something like 40 basis points on a Q-on-Q basis. Q4 was saw a one-off increase in cost because of bonus, etc. So the labor cost has actually gone up. So in Q1 there will be a normalization of that. There is a currency benefit that is also happening for Maruti, and the new launches are doing exceedingly well. So I think overall, and also they have a strong pipeline going forward. So overall, we continue to maintain a positive bias on Maruti. Okay. Remains our top pick.
Okay. Yeah. Dhananjay, what about Tata Motors though?
So Tata Motors has also been our topic, but I think it has actually been battered because of the disappointing numbers that are coming out of China, and the China slowdown has actually impacted the near-term performance of the stock and also the results. So this quarter we are expecting profits to actually decline by 45% year on year. And, you know, because of the adverse geographical mix, the margins are also likely to be low. And, you know, there is a shift of production to the China joint venture that they have. So that essentially also is a drag on the margins for the quarter. And there might be benefit from currency depreciation. If you look at pound and euro, both have actually been depreciating against the dollar. So that is a incremental positive, but that I think will still be a very minor part of it. The currency part itself could be could contribute about 30 to 20 basis point increase in margin, but that will be counterbalanced by the other major factors that I mentioned above, mentioned before. So I think this quarter will be a drag for Tata Motors. From a long-term standpoint, we continue to believe if one has a one-year view, we continue to maintain our positive bias.
Sure.
On the stock.
Okay.